Robin Walton, and I'm an art teacher here at GTMS. And I'm proud to say this is our fourth year working on this project. And this year we are doing candy dishes and dog bowls. And on top of that, another class, our MD class, is actually going to be making homemade candies and dog bones to put inside the bowls. And we're going to customize the dog bowls at the night of the show. So how the project works is we receive the bowls made. We don't make the bowls. And then students design it, the pattern, the colors, and everything that they'd like to put on their dish or their bowl. And then they glaze it. The process takes a while because every color requires three coats. After the bowl or the candy dish is glazed, it then has to go into the process of being fired into a kiln, and that takes maybe 2 days. So you can see there's many steps that go into each candy dish. This year, my seventh grade art classes did a candy bowl, and then I have two art clubs, seventh and eighth grade, and we're doing the dog bowls.
I heard that this was going to be sold at Atlantic City, and so since there weren't water, I went with a water-themed candy bowl. There's a ship here with like a stormy sky, some waves, and underneath and on the sides of the bowl you can see all the underwater creatures like octopus, the fish, and the turtles. There's also a beach on there with a crab which is just walking around. So yeah, it didn't really take me that much long to create it. It was pretty fun creating it, and I hope someone buys it.
I came up with the idea to do an Irish theme because I'm Irish and my family is like very into Irish. And since like they're for dogs, I put little dogs, like dog, different colored dog paws, and they're green. And then the yellow stands for like the gold, and like Ireland for like the chocolate coins that come with it. And I'm also an Irish dancer, so it like kind of inspired me to do an Irish theme bowl. So I just started drawing on it, and then I'm gonna paint it yellow, light green, white, yellow, all those kind of Irish colors. I've been working on it for at least like a week or two to like make sure everything's perfect so I can do everything on the bowl so I don't have to erase as much. Now I'm starting on the bowl, and then after I'm done, we'll glaze it, and it makes it like soft and not just like kind of like cement.
I think we're doing 60 or 70 candy dishes and probably maybe 30 or 40 dog bowls. And when we first did the project, I presented it in the beginning with a discussion on volunteerism and community service. And students had an opportunity to express ways that they have volunteered in the past. And we talked about how when you give something and you don't expect anything in return, how that makes you feel good. And it's a part of feeling connected with your community. So students knew why we were doing it even before they knew what they were doing. And I would say probably for the students, the hardest part of the project is giving it up. Because when you're working on something and you work so hard on something, you naturally want to keep it. You kind of have a bit of an ownership to it. But everyone's been very gracious and they've worked so hard, and so we have just beautiful bowls to share and to sell.